Praise Lord, everybody. My name is Ilda Neelam, and I thank the Lord for giving me this opportunity again that I may speak to you. Today, I'll be speaking to you about the wind and the waves obey Jesus. Now, may we all please open our Bibles to Mark chapter 4, verse 35 to 41. On the same day, when evening had come, he said to them, "Let us cross over to the other side." Now, when they had left the multitude, they took him along and in the boat as he was, and other little boats were also with him. And a great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that it was already filling. But he was in the stern, asleep on a pillow. And they awoke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" Then he arose and rebuked the wind and the sea, and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. But he said to them, "Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith?" And they feared exceedingly and said to one another, "Who can this be that even the wind and the sea obey him?" Amen. Now we all just start off that this is one of the miracles that Jesus has performed in his 3.5 years of preaching. Now in this parable, you can see that Jesus represents a human. Like same way, like we all get tired and sleepy, he, after a long day of work, he gets tired after preaching for a long time. Now, after Jesus was preaching one multitude, he was going to the other side to preach to another. And the only way to go to the other side was through the sea. Then while they were in the boat, all of a sudden, a windstorm arose. You all may be asking, what is a windstorm? A windstorm is a strong and a rough wind. This wind can change a water wave into a tsunami. And this tsunami can make a ship or a boat to break or to sink within no time. Because of the strong and big waves, the boat was being filled with water and it started to sink. Because of the boat filling with water, the people on the boat, they were scared, they were frightened. And worst of all, they had lost their faith. They were screaming and they were shouting, and they were just running everywhere just to keep themselves safe. Now, as you all may have already realized, that Jesus was not traveling alone. He was accompanied with his disciples and people. Now, the disciples, they were panicking and they were scared. They were sure that we will die. So, the disciples came down with anger to the place where Jesus was sleeping. And they shook Jesus awake. And Jesus got up and rebuked the wind and the wave and the waves to calm. The wind stopped and the waves calmed. Now the disciples were amazed, even though they were with Jesus when he turned water to wine, when he walked on water, or when he raised the dead. After the water was calm, Jesus was very disappointed in his disciples. That why were you so scared and why were they so faithless? Even though Jesus gave them the power to do what he can, but they still underestimated themselves, thinking that only Jesus has the power and the authority that he can only do it. Now, after seeing the wind and the waves coming, they were amazed that the ones who didn't even know about Jesus, they had a big question in their head. Who is he that even the wind and the waves obey him? Now, after retelling you this miracle, I want to compare this with our lives. We do face a lot of troubles which represent the wind, and we do face a lot of problems which represent the waves. Sometimes the wind and the waves are so strong that we lose faith and hope in Jesus. So please stop seeing these waves which bring tsunamis. It might make you drown, it might make you wet. But remember, most of all, it can't kill you nor destroy you. Have faith that our God is above all storms. He can calm the flood in your life. He is the controller of your life, and he had done this in the past and he will do it again. You are never alone. He is not behind you, but he is always beside you. He loves you, especially when you are in need. His special eyes is on you and his mighty hand is carrying you. Your foot will not be moved, as it is written, in Psalms 121, verse 3 to 7. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps it will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper, the Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil, he shall preserve your soul. Amen. God bless you all and thank you.